Since the introduction of the media element in the .NET MAUI Community Toolkit, this has to be the most anticipated feature yet. What that feature is and how to use it, let's go check it out in this video. Already a while ago, we introduced the media element in the .NET MAUI Community Toolkit, which allows you to play videos and audio inside of your .NET MAUI application, all kinds of multimedia. I've made a video about it earlier. You can find it down below in the notes. I would highly recommend that you check that one out as well to get all the details on how to get started. In this video, I'm going to focus on just one feature that was recently added in the media element version 3.1.0. We just released it at the time of recording and are from our core maintainer team of the toolkit project, Victor, and someone from the community who actually I think did the most work, James, has been doing amazing work to implement the highly anticipated feature full screen for media elements. So now we have full screen capabilities for iOS, for Android, and for Windows, which is really, really super cool. And macOS, of course, we had that already. I will go over the details in a little bit, but we've implemented this feature. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to get started with it, what it's all about, and let's just dive in and have a look. So here we are on my screen share, and you can actually see the Community Toolkit repository right here. This is where all the magic happens. And the reason that I'm showing this is because I'm using the sample app that is in the Community Toolkit repository today. So no file new MAUI application, but I'm going to use the sample app from this just to show you how it works. Again, if you want to know how to get started from scratch, check out the other video about the media element where I do it in a file new MAUI application. So here you can actually see there is a bug fix in here by James Crutchley, who actually did the most of the work getting this implemented together with Victor on our core team and a bunch of other people who did a good number of reviews and everything. So thank you so much. This is actually someone from the community who is spending their free time on adding this feature to the Community Toolkit. So that's really, really cool. Now everything is in here. You can see the samples folder right here. So if you pull down this repository and open Visual Studio, then you will see something like this. And this actually under samples is the Community toolkit.maui.sample. So that's the sample application. That's just a .NET MAUI application. So typically, if this were your project, what you would do is right click, do manage NuGet packages. You would do browse and you would search for community. I actually have it in here, community toolkit.maui.mediaElement. You can see it's here, 100K downloads, even more than that, 100,000 downloads, almost as much as I have subscribers on my channel, maybe. Check down below if you're subscribed and help me with that problem to reach that 100,000. That would be super, super amazing. But the Community Toolkit Media Element already has it. Version 3.1.0. So that is the version that has the full screen implemented. Add this to your project and then go into your MAUI program. This is exactly the reason why I usually start from a new project. A lot of using statements in here and then a bunch of other stuff as well. But you will recognize this MAUI app create builder inside of your new application. And then what you should do is here, do use MAUI Community Toolkit Media Element, which has set up all the renderers and handlers and that kind of stuff. And you will be good to go with the media element. So with that all in place, now for our sample application, go into pages. So we've like architected the sample application with a bunch of stuff, MVVM pattern, all of that. Go to the pages, and then under the pages, you will see all the categories, all the features basically that are inside of the Community Toolkit. And here we have views and media element, right? With a media element page. And you can see again, like, don't be daunted by all this XAML right here. There is a lot of stuff going on because we try to show you all the features, but here is the actual media element that we've implemented. This little toolkit thing, XML NS, you would need to import that at the top here, toolkit. And you can use this URL right here that will import all the namespaces for the toolkit. And then you can just use it with toolkit media element. And you can do all these properties. Should autoplay, set a width request, set a source, maybe most importantly. So we just used a file that's on the internet available, copyright free, and you can actually use that for your samples. That's some kind of a running gag. Everyone is using this video, so we are too, a bunch of events to show you how this all works. So if I just run this on my Windows machine, you will see the Windows sample application coming up. We will see the full application. and we will go to the Media Element page where we will see the video that we've linked right here. It will autoplay because that's a property that we set with all these things that you can see right here. And we should see a full screen button. So that's really, really exciting because that's what this video is all about. The application is coming up right here. You might see me struggle a little bit, little disclaimer here, because of the slowness and everything. My Windows machine broke, so this is a virtual machine through a Mac, which is all not ideal, but I've made it work to record this video just for you. The show must go on, so bear with me a little bit. And if we scroll down here to the media element, actually you can see me here, go to the menu, you will see all the features. I went to views, and now you can go to media element in that page, so let's just go here. And whenever we do, we should see this page with all the controls, all XAML now translated into this Windows UI, and you can interact with the video with all the buttons here. But if we go over this video view, the media element, you can see a new button right here, which is the full screen one. And if we click that, it actually goes full screen. Woohoo! It works, right? So we have full screen working on Windows. And if I click the button again, it will go back down. It will go back to into is window. So this is how it looks like on Windows. And I think if you look really closely, what's going on is it will actually maximize the screen and then also maximize the video player. I don't know all the things about the actual implementation here, but I know that contrary to what you might think, full screen on this video controls is super hard for some reason. So, you know, there is some custom code in there to actually make this work. And this is actually the first version that actually makes it work really nicely. Now, Windows all sorted, super cool. Now, by the power of .NET MAUI, I'm not going to change any code. I'm just going to stop running here, and I'm going to click this little menu, go to my Android local devices. I've got a physical device hooked up here to my machine. I can select this Samsung, and I can just run it again. Actually, let me not run it through Visual Studio, but I have it here. I have my screen mirrored. I already have it deployed, this exact version. And what's really cool, this is an app called Phone Link, which is built into Windows, and you can screen share out of the box with, I think only with Samsung phones, but it works for this one. So I can interact with it from here, so that's really cool, but I can also just click around from the computer right here. So super cool stuff. Again, same kind of interface, the exact same sample app. I can go to views, I can scroll down to media element, which should be somewhere here. Look at all these cool features. If you're missing one of these features in a community toolkit, I don't have a video about it yet, let me know down in the comments and I'll be sure to make it. So here we have media element. I'm going to click that. And again, same kind of interface. It starts playing and you can interact with it with all these buttons. But also, again, if I go here to the on-screen controls, you can see there is a full screen button right here. So let's click that and you can see it pops up in full screen. And you can actually see it here on the physical device as well. And what's really cool, if I'm going to hold it for landscape, you can see it automatically picks up on the orientation and it will just continue playing in full screen. And if I do it back, it will just continue playing again in portrait as well. So now I can just go out of here. I think you can swipe as well to go out of like the full screen mode and it will just continue playing on Android as well. Now I cannot show you iOS on this because it's not connected to my Mac and it's not set up. On iOS, it already worked. There was already a button for full screen, but it works slightly different than on the other platforms. It will only kind of like go full screen whenever you're playing the video. You cannot actually like pause it and that kind of stuff. It works a little bit differently. And actually, there is something interesting which I want to talk about next. I am super excited about this feature because it has been long in the making. Like I already mentioned, it's super crazy hard to do full screen on all the platforms for whatever reason, but we managed to do it in a way that's reliable and works for all the platforms, but there is still work to do. So what isn't there is a property, for instance, that lets you say like, hey, hide the full screen button. For some reason, maybe you don't want your users to do full screen videos, so you cannot really hide it. Although, you know, there is the setting for show playback controls, which shows and hides the platform playback controls, and it should adhere to that. I actually opened a button at the time of recording because it doesn't do that on Windows yet, but we're working on it. And what is super interesting is the difference between the platforms. So right now, there's not a programmatical way to actually trigger the full screen. So there's not a thing in code that you can do to say, hey, media element dot go full screen, and it goes full screen. There's nothing like that. We can only do it through user interaction right now. This is something that I know is going to come up. I know you're going to ask us like, hey, I want to set this in full screen by code. And you're totally right. That would be super, super cool. That's going to be our next challenge, I think. That's something I would love to have in there. But this is where the cross-platform development gets super interesting. Also, the challenges of a framework like .NET MAUI, it isn't available on all the platforms. So let me know your thoughts about this. I would be very curious. For iOS specifically, I already just mentioned it. For iOS, there is no way to do this on the platform. It's just not possible. There is private APIs that Apple has not enabled to the public, which you can kind of like hack into. But if Apple discovers that, and they will, during their review process, they will see you're using private APIs. This is not allowed into the App Store. You can't release your app to the store. So there's nothing we can do. So there's nothing we can do to kind of like trigger that on iOS. So if we were to implement this, and again, I want to get your thoughts. If we were to implement this, it would only work on Android and Windows, probably. We could probably make it work for there, but not for iOS. For iOS, how it would work is it would have the little window, and only when someone presses the play button or you press play from like your code, then it will go like full screen and it starts playing full screen. That's the only kind of like thing we can do. Is that something that you can live with these differences in the different platforms? Because that's the rules that we are bound to as well. Let me know down in the comments. And of course, I want to hear what your thoughts are about this amazing full screen feature and the amazing community that has implemented this. If you haven't checked out that other video about how to get started on the media element yet, please do so here, and I will be seeing you for that one.